Hey, what's going on everybody, and welcome back to another Darkfall video. And today we're going to be looking at another update for the shader library add-on version 1.9, and you can see some of the new additions in the example here. So the shader library is a free Blender add-on I've been working on. If you want to download it, there will be a link in the description. So let's go ahead and take a look at the new additions. So as usual, we need to uninstall the old version and install the new version. Once you've done that, you can press N, bring up this panel here, go down to the shader library, and we can see we have version 1.9. So yeah, go ahead and open up the cosmic shaders. So not only do we have some new additions, but I've also changed some of the existing shaders. We can take a look at this one first. Make sure you select an object, and then go ahead and click the button. Brings up this operator, and by default this was previously just an emission shader, and though it looks good in a stylized way, I wanted to make something more realistic. So we now have the option to choose between an emission shader or a principled shader, and we can see these options are the same, but we do have some new options, but we'll take a look at that in a second. Just go ahead and click OK. Now let's just change this to the render preview over here, and we can see it doesn't look too good. And that's because it's a principled shader. It's going to need some lights, so I'll make sure you add some lights. And again, play around with your lighting will make this look better. I just added these lights to quickly demonstrate the new additions, so let's go ahead and click the shader again since we've lost the redo panel. Click OK, open this up, and now let's take a look at these options. We have enable color variation options, which if you can see right now, there's a color variation between two green colors. Just enable the color variation options. There's only two options. We can change the color, and we can change the variation size, and then we also have enable shadow. So let's click this, and if it looks like this, we just need to rotate the planet since we set the lighting up in a different area. So select your planet, press R, then press Z to constrain it on the Z axis, and then just move it around until it looks correct. So you could just rotate the planet till you get something that looks better, or you can move the lights to be more correct. It's entirely up to you. But with the position, let's bring this operator back up. We can also enable city lights, so click this, and if we go around to the dark side, we can see we now have lights in the dark side. As for the options, we can change the shadow position, bring this back or forward, which will also move the lights forward as well. We can also change the shadow visibility, make it darker or lighter. And by making it lighter, we can see more of the underlying terrain. And then for the lights, we have this scale value, which is just scaling up the variation pattern. And also the strength, we can make these darker or brighter. It's entirely up to you. And as always, a little bit of bloom will make this look a lot better. So just enable bloom, play around with the settings so you get something that works for you. And while we're here, we might as well add some stars. So I'm going to Shift A, go to Mesh, add a UV sphere, scale this way up just so we're inside of it, and switch this to stars. Click the button and let's add some stars. Pretty simple. So that's the Continental World. Now let's go ahead and take a look at some of the new additions. Switch this now to Moon. Add the shader, brings up an operator. So let's just click OK, take a look at it. It's nothing special. Let's bring up the operator. So we have two scaling values. One is for the macro and one is for the micro. So macro is the big stuff. We can make this bigger or smaller. And the micro is the smaller detail. So I'll play around with that. We have the atmospheric glow, the glow amount. Again, if you want to enable shadow, you can do that too. So again, it's up to you if you want to enable that. And finally, we have a seed value. So we can get many variations on this just by moving this value. And get basically an unlimited amount of variations, I guess. That's it for the moon. Next, we have rocky world. Click add. And again, we have a whole bunch of options, but I'm just going to click OK so we can see how it looks by default. And then we can bring up the operator and then play around with whatever we want. So again, noise scale, we can play around the scale. So again, very similar to the other shaders. Now the land colors, we have land color 1, 2, 3, and 4, and we also have a watercolor. And as you can probably tell the way the colors work, this is going to be the base, and this is going to be the next color up. This is going to be the one after, and this is going to be on the very top. We can change these on the fly and give this a whole different look. Next we have this soften noise pattern. So right now it's quite detailed. If we want to soften this up and make it more cartoony, I guess, or stylized, you can do that. Or if you want, you can crunch the details and add some more. We have the atmospheric glow options. If you want to change the colors, go ahead and do that. The next addition we have is a golden world, which is a sci-fi kind of planet. And again, we have a whole bunch of options, which is very similar to the last one. The colors look very similar, but if we click OK, you can see we can get this stylized golden planet. And again, we have the options to play with, which are the same as the last shader. So again, play around with this, change the colors, change the water if you want to. Atmospheric glow, you guys get the idea by now. And then the last addition is this icy world. So again, click it, click the button, add the operator. Again, we can change all these options before we add it in, or we can just add it in and change it afterwards. It's entirely up to you. And there we go, we also have an icy planet. So yeah, go through this and play around with the colors, play around with the options and get some variations. What you could also do, if we split this window, we change this to the shader editor. And by playing around with these nodes, we have more options to get variations on planets. So again, go in here, play with some of these values and see what you get. And if you do make some cool variations and you want to share that with us, go ahead and let us know in the comments or head over to our Facebook group and share them over there. It's always great to see what you guys come up with and see how you change the shaders that I create. So I hope you find this update helpful. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. As always, thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.